You're creating your gorgeous Google Sheet, but it's taking way longer than it needs to. Well, guess what? You don't have to know advanced formatting settings to master Google Sheets. It's time to increase your efficiency with these handy Google Sheets tips for productivity. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodi, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a ton of Google tips. In today's video, I'm sharing the best Google Sheets tips for productivity. So are you ready to save time in Google Sheets? Then let's go. So let's kick things off with the best Google Sheets formatting tips, all included and bundled up for you as tip number one. If you're anything like me, you may have a lot of tabs in Google Sheets, and y'all know I'm a big fan of color blocking my GCal. Well, the same can be said for my sheets. I like to assign colors to certain tabs to know at a glance where I am in a particular process. So as an example, I use Google Sheets for billing. I like to assign colors based on the invoice status. To do so, just right-click on the tab or click on that downward facing arrow on the tab and assign it a color. Another favorite formatting tip is that if you already have a really long list of items or lots of rows in your Google Sheets, you may want to consider alternating the colors to make everything a little easier to read. So to do so, head to Format and then select Alternating Colors. Here you can choose which colors you want to alternate and if you want the header included in this section or not. And you can even pick your secondary colors too. Lastly, if you're creating a Google Sheet that needs a column of, say, yes or no answers, or maybe you need a column to act as a checklist so that you can check off something off the list once it's complete, well, you can do that too. So select the column and then head to Data and then select Data Validation. Now from this pop-up, you can choose List of Items from the criteria and then manually type in yes, no, and then select Save. So now these cells in this column have a yes or no dropdown. But to save time, you can also just make this a checklist option. So we'll head to Insert and then select Checkbox. And now there are neat little checkboxes you can tick off as needed. Google Sheets tip number two, send a link to a custom range. This is really handy if you just need someone to quickly view a specific row or column and not worry about the rest of the sheet. To do so, simply highlight the column or row you need to share, right-click on Get Link to This Range, and the link is automatically copied to your clipboard. When this person opens that URL, they'll be brought to that sheet with this range already highlighted for their attention. And if you're finding these tips valuable so far, remember to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel for even more content like this. Productivity tip number three, protect and lock specific ranges. So alternatively, if you need to share this sheet, but you don't want someone to mess with that specific range, you can set that too. So let's say we're sharing this sheet with some team members, but we don't want them to touch this column by mistake or reorganize this column. We'll select the range we want to protect. Then we're gonna head to Data, and then this time we'll select Protected Sheets and Ranges. Now from here, under the Range tab, select Set Permissions, then uncheck the email addresses for those you're sharing with, then click Done. Now only you and those you allow to change this range will be able to do so. And bonus, the exact same thing can be done for an entire sheet too. Google Sheets productivity tip number four, quickly duplicate a tab or copy a tab, complete with formatting. Ah, a time saver indeed. I'm constantly duplicating tabs within my sheets. So to do so, just head to the tab you want to duplicate, right click and select duplicate. This quickly creates another tab for you in this same sheet that you have open. That's really handy, but let's say you want to copy an entire tab over with its formatting settings to a completely new sheet. Well, you can do that too. This time, right-click on the tab and hover over Copy To. Here, you can choose to either copy this tab over to a new sheet entirely, or you can choose to add it to an already existing sheet. If you choose this second option, you can either find your spreadsheet from here, or you can grab the URL of it and just paste it into here. Either way, your tab will be copied over to the other spreadsheet with all the existing formatting in place. Voila. Google Sheets tip number 5, remove duplicate entries. Now this is a must if you're, say, running an event or have a long list or you're running a contest, maybe even signups, and you want to ensure you have the proper count. So here I am in a tab that has a list of people signed up for an email newsletter. Sometimes people sign up multiple times and we want to fix that. So we're going to highlight the table, head to data, and select remove duplicates. Now, since this particular table has a header, I'll select that option. And I just want to remove duplicates from column A. So I'll just leave that selected and then I'll hit remove duplicates. And last but not least is tip number 6, see a complete revision history of your Google Sheet. Well, you knew Google Sheets would have some of the same functionalities as found in the rest of Google Docs. This is beyond helpful if someone else makes a whoopsie in your sheet. For this one, just head to File, Version History, and select See Version History. Now this will show you the complete version history of this entire sheet, when the changes were made and by whom. But we can get even more niche. Let's say someone altered something in a specific cell and you want to know who the heck would do such a thing to your precious Google Sheet. Just right-click on the cell and select Show Edit History. And here we'll be able to see who made the changes and what changes they were and when. And don't fret, my lovely custodians or Tejaniacs, if you want a complete rundown of the best Google Sheets keyboard shortcuts, don't worry, you bet your butts I have you covered. You can click to watch that video right here or via the link in the description below. So what do you think of these Google Sheets tips for productivity? Have you tried any? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Google Sheets videos. Thanks for watching. See you next time.